Let's talk about parody. Parody is kinda dead. Or at least it must be, because I get this defense almost as much as I get the It's a Kid Show or It's Just a Cartoon defense. That whatever I'm reviewing is a parody of what I'm calling it. Teen Titans Go is a parody of the original. Seor, Seashell Party, and Stuck in the Ringer are supposed to be parodies of morals. Ren Seeks Help is a parody of being deranged. I'm going to settle this for the record. If they are parodies, they fucking suck. Whether you take them seriously or as parodies, they suck. Actually, if you take them as parodies, they suck even harder. Today, I'm going to show you the best example of parody that I could find to show you why. If you want to learn how to do a parody correctly, then you're going to have to watch this episode. Either way, this episode will show you how using the "it's a parody" excuse makes whatever I'm reviewing actually worse than I made it out to be. Let's start by talking about the cartoon Duck Dodgers. It was a pretty good show and one of my favorite Looney Tunes iterations. Although with something like Looney Tunes or Animaniacs, it's hard to explain why beyond it being funny, having creative scenarios and smart writing. Also, it has a really awesome theme song that would have been on my top 25 list if I liked pheromone music. The episode we're going to be looking at today is called Samurai Quack, and thus it brings us to the first rule of writing a parody. Convey to the audience that that's what you're doing. If Stuck in the Ringer wanted to parody morals in kids' cartoons, then they massively failed, because teaching a moral is legitimately what it seemed like they were going for. There wasn't any wit to it, and the episode that surrounds that seemed to be building up to that climax without any sort of subversion. You don't have to name your episode similar to what you're parodying, like this episode is parodying Samurai Jack, but you do have to let people know what you're doing in some way or another. This is what changes Atlantis Square Pandas from a homage to a ripoff. A framing device is very useful in doing this, and it's the easiest way, but it's not entirely necessary. Hell, you don't even have to start off in the parody, like this episode does here. It starts with Daffy being awoken by his alarm clock.
Ha ha ha! Happy cats say nap time is over.
By the way, that's not an imitator. They were that dedicated to the parody that they got both Kennedy Tartar Sauce and Mako to voice act. You don't need to have that kind of dedication, but dedication itself is highly important. You need to know what you're trying to parody inside and out. You need to know the basic formulas, the tropes and cliches that every episode uses. If you're going to parody Western, watch as much Western movie and television as you can. This is essentially to show respect to whatever you're parodying, and I'll get to that as we go along. Daffy finds Porky trying to make sushi, and apparently he was sleeping for 3 days. As soon as Porky goes to wash his hands, Daffy starts serving himself up some sushi. Because he doesn't know what he's doing, he ends up eating a pufferfish and gets knocked out. Now we come to the most important rule of writing a parody. Having your characters, you know, be your characters. Whether you want to do a silly parody or a serious parody, the main drive of your story is to have your characters play off whatever world they come across, in the way that only they can. It doesn't work if your characters are out of character, or, you know, bastardized beyond all belief. Hi, Teen Titans Go! If you actually took the effort to get your characterization down pat, your show might actually be funny, rather than insulting. This is by and large what separates a good parody from the bad parody. If you don't do this, then we're by and large watching an entirely different show. And we didn't come to your show for that, we came to your show for your show. Now, one decision that you have to make is to be funny or to be serious. You can do both, but it is difficult, and you've got to play to your strengths. This is very easy to screw up. By and large, most parody is, or tries to be, funny. Because if you do serious wrong, you end up being one of the most mediocre offerings in whatever you're trying to parody. Not exactly an animated atrocity, but nothing worth watching. You see, if this episode actually tried to be a legitimate episode of Samurai Jack, it would be boring and tedious. Instead, they go for the comedy. Now, if you do that, do not be afraid to be disrespectful. Don't try to be disrespectful, but try and get as close to the original style and subvert your audience's expectations. Reduce the seriousness to silly. This episode went through the monumental effort of matching the style of Samurai Jack perfectly in order to play with it. From having a style with no outlines, to making fun of the long walking done at the first act of most Samurai Jack episodes, they get the style down perfectly, until it's time for the action. Because they have the style down so well, the characters react to it like the characters from their own show. Like Daffy here trying to push the bars away. Also, if you want to do something seriously, make sure that you have the budget to cover their style. Duck Dodgers did not have the budget to do a serious Samurai Jack episode, and it kinda shows in the fight scene here.
You're lucky I didn't cut you to ribbons.
Not with a Y7 rating you won't.
Ah yes, the best kind of jokes you can make with this kind of parody are jokes about the meta sense of whatever you're paying homage to. Your characters end up in a book, have them play with the pictures in the pages. They end up in movies, have them see the audience, complain about the rating, etc.
Only the evil tyrant wizard, the master of masters, Achoo, has the power to send you home.
Okay, better than saying don't be afraid to be disrespectful would be don't be afraid to be silly. And yes, give your characters plenty of opportunity to act as themselves. If they have an opposite trait to the main character of what you're homaging, use it. Remember, when you're not telling jokes or just having your characters react, get as close to the original as you possibly can. This will allow the audience to build back their expectations.
To do the impossible, I must call upon the strength of my ancestors. Hey, Dad! Can I have an people to go to the movies?
This is important. Variety is always a good idea. Not every single joke should involve the parody. It can get repetitive if you do. If you're wondering, Achoo is pretty much Aku in its entirety. There are, like, no difference but the name. And if you're doing a direct parody, you've got to get those characters right, too. Going off topic for a minute now, be careful if you're doing an episode-long or movie-long parody directly, because copyright law is shit nowadays. Yes, it's considered fair use, but just be careful. Considering that Gennady was here, the Duck Dodgers team obviously had permission and blessing. If you're doing this right and, you know, not ripping off whatever you're trying to homage or parody, you should be totally fine. Now, the battle here hits all the right notes, bringing up the right cliches and makes some of them in the right way. I don't really want to spoil any of them, but they've really done their homework, and none of these jokes sound out of place.
I think it's a monkey wearing lederhosen.
Except that one. Someone really just wanted to hear Aku say monkey wearing lederhosen. And you know what? Now that I've heard it, I don't blame him. Also, don't be afraid to homage more than one thing. That electric bolt brings Daffy back to reality. Now, if I had one criticism to this episode, it's that it's pretty anticlimactic not having Daffy win or even really lose. But that wasn't the point. It was just to have a brief and funny stint in another show. And you know what? It really paid off being one of the best examples of parody that I could find.